When DaVinci Resolve 20 released, it came with a bunch of exciting new and updated features, right? Promising perfect results with one click of a button. But turns out that sometimes the results are a bit disappointing, not so perfect. And even with a lot of manual tweaking, you might not get the result you want. And that's why today I'm going to show you two examples of how you can make the already powerful tools and effects in DaVinci Resolve 20 10 times more powerful. Perfect result every time. But small disclaimer, small one, if you want to try this out yourself, you're gonna have to turn your heart to stone. Because your computer will make sounds that you've never even heard before, and it might even call for its mommy. Yeah, because what I'm gonna show you today, well, it just asks a lot from your computer and the GPU. So you have been warned. Here we go. Okay, and step one is depth map. Depth map basically allows you to make a selection based on how far an object is from the camera. So, you know, it understands the 3D structure of an image. But wait, it's a lot easier if I just show you how it works. So look, in the color page, you can find it under effects. Just drop it on a node and boom, this is what a depth map looks like. So the darker areas represent objects farther away from the camera, while brighter areas represent objects closer to the camera. And here in the settings, you can adjust the far and near limit, and there's a bunch of other settings that you can use to fine-tune your selection, the mask. You can make it a gradual transition to the background, see? Or you can make it a harsher transition. And this allows you to make all kinds of adjustments based on distance. For example, you can brighten the subject or the foreground of your scene very realistically. Or you can change the color temperature of the background, for example. Then you just have to invert the mask. And it all looks super realistic because it's all based on depth and the distance to the camera. Okay, so that's depth map. And now let me show you how depth map can make another tool, Relight, 10 times more powerful. Let's add the Relight effect, and you use Relight to enhance or adjust the lighting of your scene. So it also uses the scene's depth information to simulate how light would realistically interact with different surfaces and objects. But it's not always super accurate, and the results don't always look super realistic. Look, let's go for a directional light here. And then uncheck this box so we can see the image. And now all you have to do, for example, is increase the gain. So you add more light to the scene, see? And it's supposed to realistically relight the scene, right? And at first glance, it looks okay, but look here. Next to my head, there's this weird shadow that doesn't look right. It's like a shadow on the background, but it's not supposed to be there. And also here, on the other side of my head, it's all glowy and weird. And you can try to fix it with all the relight settings and parameters, but a lot of times it's just not possible to fix it. But there is a way to actually fix it, and you'll get a perfect result. All you have to do is combine relight and depth map. Look, so just add depth map before the relight effect, then make a nice selection of myself, and then feed the depth map masks information into the relight effect by connecting the blue triangles here. And boom, look, there. Looks a lot better. Perfect. Well, almost perfect. I see a bit of weird things here on my shoulder. So the depth map needs some tweaking. Let's go back to the depth map and apply post-processing here. It looks 10 times better than before. And it took, what, 1 minute? And because depth map is based on distance, and light is also, you know, affected by distance, it will keep the relight effect looking realistic, you know? Okay, let me give you another example. Two tools that, also combined, are super powerful. But first, guys, if you're still looking for the perfect music platform, maybe you should check out Audiio, the sponsor of this video. I use Audiio for literally every video I make. Music, sound effects, they have everything. And it's all music from real artists, so people who are passionate about making music, and that of course makes all the difference. You can use their music for personal and client work, and they even offer a lifetime plan. So that's a one-time payment for unlimited music. Now, if you want to use all the super cool AI features to help you find the perfect song in just a few seconds, Then make sure that you go for the Pro subscription, which is just $59 for the first year if you use my link and code in the description. So go to their website, start listening to some music, because maybe Audiio is the one for you. Okay, and now back to DaVinci Resolve. Another example, two tools combined, super powerful. Okay, first Chroma Warp. And Chroma Warp allows you to precisely manipulate colors very locally. You can use it to select and shift specific hues in an image, and it's more refined and more powerful compared to some of the older tools. But of course, sometimes the result is not super perfect. For example, let's say I want to change that salmon peach color of her blouse to more like a yellow, more like the girl's blouse. Well, all you need to do is go to the color warper, make sure that the chroma warp is selected, and then click on her blouse, and it will indicate that color that you clicked on in the chroma warp tool, see? And then all you have to do is drag it towards yellow. But because that salmon peachy color is so close to skin color, it's affecting all the faces in the image. And even the chair here. And then you can start fiddling around with the settings, but you know, you won't get it right because the colors are just too similar. But again, there's a super easy fix if you combine the Chroma Warp tool with another awesome tool, Magic Mask. All you have to do in the same node is just go to Magic Mask, select the blouse, make sure that you have everything, fine-tune it a little bit, and then tweak the Chroma Warp again until it looks perfect. And look how realistic it looks. No one will ever know that this was not a yellow blouse. And that's how you can make the powerful tools in DaVinci Resolve 20 powerful, but sometimes not so perfect, 10 times more powerful, with perfect results every time. So next time you're a bit disappointed when you're using a tool, think, because there's always a way to, you know, combine it with one or more other tools to make it look perfect. That's it. I hope it helps, guys. Just practice it, you know, start experimenting. Thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next one.